For all of those English, those who are in my English Ways of Israel group, question we have to ask ourselves, trust only in God or also in God? It's written in the Chovot HaLevavot Sha'ar HaBitachon, chapter 3, that one must put his trust in God alone. It is insufficient to trust in him while at the same time relying on others to come to one's aid as well. This is known as a Shiftuf, and by Judaism, we do not hold by Shiftuf an associate that will come to the rescue. It's either God or God alone. This is supported by what is written also about King Asa, king of Judah, in 2 Divrei HaYamim, chapter 16, verse 12. And this is the book of Chronicles, chapter 2nd book of Chronicles, chapter 16, verse 12. But ill as he was, he did not turn to the Lord, but to physicians. And he was punished for relying also on physicians. In other words, he trusted in them as well as in God. This is what we talk about, association. In whom he believed, being a righteous king. There's nothing wrong in seeking the help of doctors when one is ill. As a matter of fact, it's normal, it's a custom. But Asa apparently relied on them excessively. The author proceeds to prove that someone who puts his trust in one person and then relies on another as well does not actually trust the first one either. It is therefore obvious that one who trusts in God and in a human being as well shows that he does not really trust in God's ability to save or to redeem. There's a reason enough for God to not to fulfill his expectation, as we find in Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 5. Cursed is he who trusts in man, who makes mere flesh his strength. Let me say that again, because this needs to be repeated, because we have so many in the Jewish fold who have come to trust in man, let me put it this way, in rabbis, even very righteous rabbis, expecting them to save them from their predicament by their blessings and their powers, and when it fails, their faith fails them. Same thing happened in the world of Christianity, where they lifted up a human being to become, as it were, a God-made flesh. In the Hasidic world, you could see that as the enclothement of the divine in a body. Yet, we are told repeatedly through the prophets and through the Torah, cursed is he who trusts in man, who makes mere flesh his strength. Chovot HaLevavot apparently interprets this verse as referring not only to one who trusts in man alone, but also who relies jointly on a man and on God. In other words, as a go-between, as a mediator. Of course, one who must strive to prove one's condition. The author himself states that one must strive to attain good health, but is not supposed to rely on medicine, etc., but believing that it will make him healthy, one should rather trust in God's will. Rambam seems to contradict what he states in Deot 4:20, that he guarantees good health to anyone who follows the rules of healthful living. Perhaps he's referring to preventing illness and not to healing illness and one who is sick and trying to recover. Remember Psalms 103, bless the Lord. And when we think of God, we bless him. He provides all the goodness and beneficence to us. It is not a human being. Even everything that's bestowed upon human beings is a byproduct of God's grace and goodness upon human beings. When you put your trust in a creation instead of the creator, you come out empty-handed. When you put your faith only in God and God alone, then you receive a direct blessing from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And this is what Judaism is all about. It is not to be emphasizing human beings and go-betweens. Even the Messiah himself, when he comes, which he has not yet come, when he comes, we're putting our faith in God that he's in fact sending him. And we have to prove that he's in fact the Messiah. Not the opposite way around, just believe him because he is and he says he is. This was the big difference between these decoy messiahs that have come through Jewish history and the true one that we saw in the case of Moses, Moshe Rabbeinu, who basically, after God himself proved to the children of Israel, this is the one I'm sending. He is my messenger. It's only after the fact that he redeemed and took the children of Israel out of Egypt that it states in the Torah, and they believed in God and Moshe, his servant. And notice the word, his servant, not God in flesh. I wish you a wonderful week and keep on studying Torah. Encourage Torah studying at all levels. Shalom, bracha to all of you.